Dear students and viewers, this is a Teta Morogoro. I'm Mwachahe Mutua. I'm teaching English language form 4 students. As today I'm going to introduce a poem of Songs of Lawino, which was written by our own child from Uganda called Pibitek. Please can you join with me to enjoy this fruitfulness poem from Uganda, especially at the northern area in Uganda. You are all welcome. Now, as you can see on the blackboard there, Songs of Lawino Undercover, a poet or a writer called Okoth Kibitek in Uganda, a publisher called East African Education Publisher. A book was published towards 1979. Now, before I proceed, the specific objective which should be considered by students or recognized, like the following. Students are expected to be able to identify and analyze. Number one, there is a setting within a poem, plots or scenario or events or sequence which are formed within a poem. The other issue, there is a plot. The other issue, there is a characters. Another, there is a characterization. Themes and the relevancy of a poem. Now, before proceeding, I would like to start with the setting of a poem. As I told you that a book was set in Uganda, at northern Uganda from a Korean tribe. As I explained a lot about the main two characters, Akol and Lawino. These are main speakers which are formed within a poem. As Akol with her own husband, Lawino, whom they came from a Korean tribe in northern Uganda. Okoth was born in Buru town, northern Uganda, in 1981. And he is a Korean by tribe. His father was a teacher at Buru Mission Center. Now, and his mother was a composer and the singer of a Korean tradition, songs. Okoth got his education from Guru High School, Government Training College, University College, and of Wales and Oxford University from United States of America. Now, as you can see on the blackboard, there is a picture of a car, a famous poet who came from Uganda. This you can see, students. This is the one who composed a poem which, let's say, it explains more about the African tradition in general and the introduction of new culture or westernization style in Africa. Now, another, there is a picture of a book, Songs of Lawino. As you can see, Lawino here, let's say, he is still plotting for her own culture from a Korean tribe. And once you see there, also there is a call. Let's say once we read the first chapter, Lawino says that my husband time now is bitter. Means that her own husband, the call now, starts insulting or betraying her own wife, Lawino. Now, summary of the poem. My dear brothers and sisters, or dear students and viewers, once we read the summary of a poem, it means that almost there are two participants or characters who are still adding each other, like Okol and her own husband and her own wife, Lawino. How? Maybe from the first chapter to the end of the chapter, Lawino speaks a lot about a culture of Africa or traditionalist of Africa, like cooking, wearing style, and eating style too. But in the other way too, once you read a lot about Akol, he insults the general things or the general culture of Africa. And he starts imitates all things about the Western culture in general. That's the quality of summary of a poem. But once you see Akol and Lawino are the main two characters within a poem, all of them they came from a Korean tribe. And not only that, but also Okol was mainly Lawino. As the dear students and viewers, now let us go to pass through each chapter, as we have 13 chapters. So far, can we pass from one chapter to another chapter to see how a fruitfulness of a poem which was written by our own child in Uganda, it's so very good and proud to her. It's so very amazing. As now we are going to see a section number one, as in this section, chapter Laweno laments about a call since he got education. Means that since the adaptation of education, a call starts inserts or betraying her own husband, her own wife, Laweno, that he don't know even to write a letter A. She is a pagan, primitive way, and the uncivilized woman who came from a Korean tribe. So far, that's why Laweno asks that her tanko for own husband now is bitter. As you can read from a chapter, Laweno was totally changed from each and everything from Africa. Even, let's say, as you can see on the blackboard, there are from, let's say, eating style, walking style, greeting style, sleeping style, all of them was imitated from European countries. Even, let's say, a style of work, a style of wearing the clothes, all of them was adapted from European culture. As now too, you can see our general societies in Africa, we are still imitated each and everything from European countries. The way of walking, the way of eating food with a fork or with a spoon, it is still a new culture to Africa in general. That is still a chapter number one. Number two, in this section there is a new scenario as the woman introducing Clementine as a woman whom she share a love or her husband. Means that once he went to the Western nation, once he was studying at University, Oxford University, he was got a new concubine who was called the Clementine, let's say a modern girl from European countries, a girl who was wearing a short skirt, making a lip shiny, and let's say using a wig around her head. This is how Laweno now introduces that a woman whom she share a love with your car. So far, that is called in section number two. As it is still continuing, Western countries and Laweno is against with the cosmetics, wearing wigs, slimming. She thinks that she can make a competition with Clementine, on by welcoming her husband warmly in the preparation of good meals and how to wear on a piece of kanga during Betty's night. Means that in this chapter, Laweno, as let's say now there is a competition of love between, let's say, another woman whom called Clementine. There is still a competition of love. Due to that, Laweno says that the only method of winning a husband is only, let's say, you get a hot water to her own husband, okay, and wearing one piece of kanga maybe during a night or night bed. Sure that those who are already, they know that system. Now, section 3. In this chapter, you see Laweno is totally against all cultures that they are meaningless, immoral, and unhygienic. And due to the habit of kissing in public and changing or dancing during the night. Once you see there is a lot like smoking and wearing improper dresses. Not only that, but wearing a night dress during the night. And Laweno admires her catch of dancing during the daylight in the open space. Means that in that way, Laweno, she is totally against the Western culture. Like the way of dressing, those, white girls, they wear a short skirt, use their cosmetics, use their lip shine. Means that, so in that way, Laweno totally against that thing. Number four. Section number four, once you read in details, in deep way, means that Laweno appreciates her own culture from Africa. As she speaks that to Okoro, that Okoro, do you remember once you told me, you love my small breast while I was young? Do you remember that? Dear students and viewers, can you see a picture there? These are some pictures from a Korean tribe in Uganda. As you see here, there is a girl from a Korea, very black beauty indeed. As nowadays, boys are still loving the girls whom they are so very black more than they think. You can see yourself with your eyes. Also, there are another picture too. Like this one too. A picture which shows a small breast for the girls from a Korean tribe in Uganda too. This is how Lawino was admired or was applauding for her own culture in Uganda. That is how she stands thinly from the chapter up to the end of the chapter. Oh, another picture too. It shows the way how our Korean people, especially the women, see they are applauding for their own culture in Uganda. This is how to you, let's say, like a student, so you must applaud for your own culture, which you go with it. Oh, another way too, there is a picture too, which shows it like this way. These also, let's say, all of the people from Korea, Taiwan, Uganda. You see there is a girl, and also there are boys here to the left-hand side. All of these means that it explains a lot of the way how Lawino admires or applauding of our own culture from Northern Uganda. Now, dear students, that is how Lawino admires her own culture. Now let us see our chapter or section number 4. But this also it is still continuing. But let us continue in section number 5. Lawino continues despising the European culture. It was insulting the European culture. It means that they are immoral. As you can see, but let's say she goes against all those cosmetics, which are still nowadays very useful even to our girls or to our women around our societies nowadays. As you can see, there are, like, let's say, once you live within your section, express beauty of African culture and the way of attracting men, not Western culture. And they treat their hair like a walking corpse or a dead pastor and wearing wigs. As you can see, there is a picture. This is how these current girls, or modern girls, how they use the cosmetics so as to attract the men see whom they allow me. As you can see, this one, the first one, there is the second one, let's say a woman who's using a wig. And the next, there is the issue of lip shine or lipstick too. And the last one, there is a girl who wears a short skirt. As you can see, this picture, nowadays is the serious fashion to most of the girls in Africa too. Even less, maybe they can be my sisters, I don't know. But please, dear students, can you look at your environment? These people are just around me. We are still living with them. It is so very shameful. As you can see, a girl like this, maybe take here an example, maybe she is your sister, and then she wears like this. So very stupidity. So it means that we must ignore this body culture or this body wearing system of European culture. More than it, we must applaud for our own culture in Africa. Now, section number 6. Once you come to section number 6, Lawino speaks to herself that she is really ignorant for not being able to eat tea with a spoon and forks. And she is totally despite the tasteless of tiny and the frozen foods. Dear students, once you read in details, means that Lawino sure that she truly speaks that she don't know to use a spoon, even to use a fork. But also, let's say, her own husband, Okoro, speaks like that. Insults her own husband that he don't know even to read a Bible or to cook with a kerosene stove. That's how Lawino clearly, let's say, tells herself that she don't know to use those things which was bloated or which was bloated by a European nation or Western people or white people. Also, let's say, occult section number seven, there is also the issue of naming the people. Means that instead of using our own names in Africa, we use the European names like John, David, Joyce. Why do we have our own names from Muhehe, from Sukuma, from Ngoni? Let us use our own names rather than plucking the European culture. Also, let's say Paul insults, let's say Lawino insults her husband that he is wasting time through using a watch rather than using the traditional system of watching the sun. Those maybe you know, those let's say the elders that our own village always they look once maybe you ask a person maybe which is time he or she can look to the sun and then he can reply to you let's say a kind of time. But Lawino here laments or insults her own husband that he was wasting the time to wear a watch like this. But once also you can see on the blackboard there is a watch. Let's say all of these was introduced by the European nation or the whites from Europe and the Western nation too. So far, we must proud our own culture. That's why the system which was we inherited from our forefathers, the issue of looking the sun and then you say time which you know. Chapter 8. Once you read chapter 8, Lawino continues to go against the European culture or the white culture as the introduction of new religion as Christianity. She is totally against reading a Bible in a religious modern way. As we call nowadays, there are, let's say, we call it the saints, or let's say another, they call it bishops. They remove our sins to the human being through maybe preaching a pastor. Lawino doesn't agree with that. As you can see, there is a picture of Bible. Let's say you are the God who sees me, means that our own God can see you. Or these are the words or scriptures of God. But Lawino totally agrees with that. Let's say she continues to say that she will continue with her own traditionalist, which she still found in Uganda. And not only that, condemn the way how these people are still preaching. Chapter 9. Lawino continued lamenting about the new religion and continued to ask who is Virgin Birth and the Eucharist. Those maybe who are Christian and not sure that they know about the Virgin Mary within Catholic and the Eucharist. Sure that you will agree with me. I'm Catholic too. So I'm so very proud of my new religion. Students, all together. Section 10. In this chapter, I will complain that your call is against the Afro culture. Means that Okoro was rather left those things which he gone with from a Korean tribe. As in, let's say, like those African medicine. Now Okoro, he admires the medicine from European countries. Dear students, here there is a picture which shows, let's say, a witch doctor. Show that those who came from the village, not only the village, but also at the time, these witch doctors are still present. In other way, in the Swahili version nowadays, they call it Sangoma. Sure, students, you know them. As you can go there, maybe he can tell you that please can you bring a lady here. So far, maybe he or she can cure you. That is seriously a system of curing through traditional way in the African continent. So far, in that way, Lawino continues to use those African medicine more than European medicine. Section 11. Lawino attacks the local leaders of the political parties in Uganda, means that they are still, let's say, due to the quarrel on each other. So far, in that way, Laguna showed that she don't like that way because Laguna, let's say, quarreling her only brother, they quarrel themselves due to the political system. Section 11. And dear students and viewers, this is how we enjoy a poem. Show that a poem of songs for Laguna is so very enjoyable, or more than overjoyful. Once you read the section 11, Laguna continues to go against the European culture or the westernization system or modernization system. As here she speaks about the education which was still copying and pasting from European countries. As maybe you can see, maybe the graduates from different universities, let's say they were, once they graduated, and then after that they will be receiving, let's say, a certificate. After that they go to the, let's say, to search the employment. So far, in that way, Laguna goes against total. So far, the estimate of me was, sure that you can agree with me that we are still copying and pasting each and everything from the European countries. Even the way of reading, the way of eating, the way of loving or marrying each other, all of them we are still imitating from the European countries. Now, this is the last chapter. In this session, Laguna advised her husband that he must gain his manhood, and according to her, he can do that by begging for forgiveness of others, offering traditional sacrifice, using tradition and medicine. So it means that Laguna now advised her own husband that he must go to the elders so far to beg for forgiveness. Show that this is, let's say, the way of African people. Once maybe you go along with your elders, you go in front of them, then they speak a blessing word for you, and after that you continue with your life in a good way. Thank you very much, my dearest students. This is how we passed it through each chapter to see a summary how, let's say, Kol and Laguna are still arguing each other or going against each other. But once you read more, means that Okol and Laguna, in both, let's say, Laguna, she is still, let's say, admiring her own culture from the first chapter up to the end chapter. But once you go to the side of Okol, means that Okol, he is totally against the African culture. Means that he is going with the European system way of life. This is how these chapters are still explaining these two people. Now, we are going now to start our analyzation of our own poem, as we will start with the characters. I would like to group you, let's say, you must exchange your ideas within your group, from group number one up to the group number five. Share your ideas and then at the end, write it in a good way, and at the end, you must correct it. So far, we'll remark next time. Now, there is a marking scheme here of those, let's say, that question. A conflict is the misunderstanding between one person against the other. Maybe example within a book, we read a conflict between Laguna and her husband, to how it was explained within a book. Or another conflict, there is a conflict between a call and her own, let's say, his traditionalist in Uganda. It is still also a conflict. Or in another way too, there is a conflict between Okolo and African culture in general. Another, there is a call and his family in general. Another, there is a Laguna versus Clementine due to the sharing of love. Means that a Laguna, Clementine was a concubine of Okolo. We call it in the Swahili version in Chepuko. They call it in Chepuko Ndiodini. show that expectancy, have you already here, let's say, when like that? Now, that is still, let's say, those are some questions from that exercise or quiz which I gave you from our last session. Now, now we're going to continue with another themes which are still found within Abuku. Another thing, there is a mental colonization. Once you read Abuku, it means that Okolo was totally mental colonized by the European nations. As you can see from my book, means that wearing style, eating style, marrying style. And even nowadays, these people are still around within our societies. We have them, even at maybe at our house or at our living environment, which we are still living. These people are just living, we are living with them too. So once you see within a book, let's say, there is a picture here, let's say, this is called mental colonization. Let's say a person with her own husband. Let's say a woman carries her own husband at the back, like you can see. This is called mental colonization. We should stop this. Now, another issue, then, like the issue of blind pass. The issue of marrying maybe a girl and then you sent a blind price, this is still a custom in Africa or a tradition in Africa. Once you see a blind price, this is seen from a book as value to the African people for paying a blind price if they want to marry. And this is very from a book as others go off to Pajure to look for blind price. Means that these people was going at Pajure. Pajure is still a place where people was going to see a blind place, maybe for their, let's say for their sisters who was wanted to maybe to marry with that period. So far, once you see even our living society nowadays, maybe they can say maybe you would pay maybe a cows, 10 cows, and maybe 10 goats and 40 shillings. This is to see a custom. Examples, let's say, as it then in Iringa, this system is still present up now. Once many want to marry a beautiful girl from Iringa, make sure that you prepare well, my dear brothers and sisters. As maybe almost, let's say, we start by, let's say, 40 cows and 40 goats and, let's say, 10,000 shillings. This also, we are still paying in our own tradition. But also maybe if we can go to the Sukuma people, although let's say they like white girls, once they see white girls, means that sure that they attract with the white girls in Mwanza, in Shinyanga, and other places around in coastal. Once you see on the blackboard, there is a blind, let's say there are people who are marrying each other, and there is maybe a person who gave them a Bible. This is how a blind person is still existing within our society. Now, dear students, this is how we enjoy a poem. Another thing, there is the issue of responsibility. The simple way is the way a person fulfills his or her things or her job. Once you read a poem in deep way, it means that Lawino was really responsible as she was carrying her own children without her own husband at home. This is how, let's say, a woman nowadays, this let's say, it is still existing within our society. You can see there on the screen, there is a woman who fulfills her own job or duties with her own husband. I'm not sure that they are still preparing a cake. I don't know. Another issue, there is the issue of responsibility, whereby a person does not fulfill his or her responsibility or duties. From a book, if you read in a deep way, Okal does not fulfill his own duties, maybe of caring the children and paying the school fees to the children too. This is also still currently existing within our societies. Means that there are some of the men or men who are not fulfilling well their jobs at home. Now, another issue there is the issue of lack of education. We request means that our person lacks education. A poet used the character Lawino, show that she lacks education. Show that Lawino herself tells that she don't know the read a Bible. Means that she was not yet went to school. Even in our society, this issue is still present. Most of the people are not going to school, especially maybe for the girls. Soon after getting maybe let's say at the school, once maybe they get